Hello students, I am going to begin my series of lectures for 11th and 12th chemistry. My first lecture is on solutions. Today is the first lecture one on solutions. Solutions are nothing but homogeneous mixture of two or more than two substances. But you already know that at your home, you are using most of the times mixtures, and in the mixtures, I am talking of solutions. For example, if you take water and put salt in it, you will find that the salt dissolves in the water, and you cannot see the salt which you added in the water. So it is an example of a homogeneous solution. The salt has got dissolved in the water. The salt was in solid, NaCl was in solid form. When you dissolved in water, all you see is a clear solution. But if you will taste it, you will see the saline taste in this. So we are talking of solutions. We are saying that solution is nothing but homogeneous mixture. I have used the word homogeneous mixture. And I am saying I am mixing two or more than two components. Or more than two substances or components. The examples, you already know the aerated drinks which you are drinking, and when you go to the chemist shop and buy some liquid syrups, etc., you find they are solutions. They have more than one components, but the composition is uniform throughout. The composition is uniform throughout. This is an important point. That the composition is same in every part of the solution which you can take. You can dissolve sugar in water, or you can dissolve urea in water. You can form different type of solutions. Air is also a mixture. Air is a mixture of gases. In this you have nitrogen, oxygen and few other gases. Similarly, if you take alloys, you take brass, you take bronze, coinage metals, German silver, they have more than one metal present in them. But the composition is uniform throughout. So you can see that what I am talking, that the solution may not be only putting solid in a liquid. The solutions can be your solid solutions, liquid solution or gaseous solution. We'll like to see what type of solutions are there. Now whenever in our course we will be mostly interested in binary solutions. Now when I say it is a binary solution, when I use the word bi, di in chemistry, it is clear that I have two components. What I have is two components. The component can be solid, liquid or gas. Now binary solutions means there will be two things, and we use the terms solvent, and second I use the term solute. I am saying that the solvent is that component which is present in larger amount. So I am saying it is present in larger amount. And I am saying solute is that which is present in smaller amount. Most of the time we are using that, but sometimes the solvent can also become a solute depending on the quantity. How we define the quantity in grams or in milliliters or sometimes in moles. So we'll like to see when I talk of the solvent and solute, it is a relative term, which is larger, which is smaller. Or sometimes if they are equal in amount, then we may consider any one of the two, solvent or solute. Sometimes we use a physical state. I am saying the physical state is also important in many cases. For example, when I put salt in water, the salt is no longer in the solid form, it dissolves in water. So the physical state of the solution becomes liquid. So therefore we can take the liquid as a solvent in that case. So I can say water is the solvent when I am dissolving solute like sodium chloride in water, because sodium chloride takes the state of the liquid when it gets dissolved. So you can see the mixture is not only homogeneous, but there is a change in the identity of the solute and solvent when solutions are formed. And it is not possible to separate the solute and the solvent by simple physical methods like filtration, etc. So we will be talking of solute and solvent. When I say it's a solution of 10% solution of sugar in water, what it means that there is 10 gram of the sugar dissolved in 10% means 100 grams of the solution. 100 grams of the solution. We will like to see these terms very soon. So I am saying they are solvent, solute. Now let me talk about the types of the solution. What types of solutions are possible? I said there can be gaseous solutions. There can be liquid solutions. And there can be solid solutions. Three types of solutions. And total it will become 9. When I say gaseous, I have already said here is a mixture of gases, liquid solution. When you mix one liquid in another liquid like alcohol, you are putting in water, ethanol in water. Solid solution, you are putting sodium chloride, sugar or anything in water which dissolves. So there are three types of solutions. The state, the gaseous solution means the solvent is the gas. Solvent is the gas. Here I am saying the solvent is the gas. So the physical state of the solvent identifies the type of the solution. When I say liquid solution, here the solvent is liquid. The solvent is liquid. And when I am saying solid solution, what is happening here? The solvent is my solid. That means solid which is present in larger amounts. Let us see how many types of solution will be possible. In the NCERT book, you have seen there is a table which they have given, in which they have identified the different types of solutions according to, I am saying, types of solutions. Type of solution. Supposing I say gaseous solution. Gaseous solution. In gaseous solution, the solvent, there will be a solute and the solvent. The solvent will always be gas in this case. So if I put a gas, any gas, for example, if you are putting oxygen gas and nitrogen, which is our air, it is an example of a gaseous solution. These are the examples which I am giving. Now you can put a liquid in a gas. So we can put, supposing you put chloroform in nitrogen, if you put chloroform in the nitrogen, so what type of solution will be this? This will be a liquid in gas. Or you know that you have water vapors in air. Air is a gas. So here also you will see that the liquid is present in the air, is present in the humidity. What we talk of humidity. You know what is humidity? There is a water vapor which is present in the air. Then you can have, when the solute is solid and you have a gas, you can put camphor is a solid in the nitrogen gas. In the nitrogen gas. So these are the examples which I said, these are gaseous solutions. These are gaseous solutions because in this solute it can be gas, liquid or solid. If I take liquid solutions, in a liquid solution, what will happen? The solvent will be liquid. The solvent is liquid. The solvent is liquid. And I can put gas in liquid. For example, oxygen gas is dissolved in water liquid. There is already some amount of oxygen present in the liquid water. So this is example of the gas in liquid, which is, again I am saying, a liquid solution. You can put liquid solute in liquid. For example, you take ethanol, which is a liquid, and put in water, it will be a solution, liquid solution. Then you can put solid. You already know you can put sugar in. Sugar is a solid, you put in water, it becomes a solution. So these are the types. Liquid solution. Then I can have solid solutions. Solid solution means my solvent will be solid. If my solvent is solid, then I can put gas in solid. You have heard about in organic chemistry, we are using large number of catalysts like palladium, nickel, platinum. And what we do, we have hydrogen gas. It gets adsorbed over the surface of palladium. So it is example of gas in solid solution. Then I can put liquid in solid. For example, you have mercury is a liquid, you put in sodium solid. So this is called an amalgam, which finds great uses in chemistry. Then I am talking, for example, now I am talking of alloys. No, what we do, if you put copper, if you put solid in solid, for example, you can take copper, you put in gold. So, you know, 24 karat gold is very pure and jewelers mix copper in that in order to make the jewelry. So you can see that total of how many states? 3 plus 3 plus 3, there are 9 types of solutions which I have shown on the board. In my lecture 2, I will talk about the various methods of expressing the concentrations of the solutions.